sometimes when you score a knockdown, you start to think it's going to be an easy night. And you forget what you knew when you came in. That wasn't going to be an easy night. You're going to have to bring all the tools out of the tool shed. And it's important to remember that.
Able to get away from that headshot with the block. Mike Tyson will have to hope his corner knows how to handle a cut. Nice block by Tyson.
Finish with the hook.
Dismisses his opponent's headshot. Oh, that's good stuff. Fires right back with one of his own. Good work by Mike Tyson.
Mike Tyson, the youngest heavyweight champion ever, claiming all three belts, unifying the title, then of course making a ragdoll out of Michael Spinks.
Oh, Muhammad Ali's almost out of it there. He was stunned. Nice block by Ali. And a sharp counter punch by Tyson.
Come on, come on.
Muhammad Ali's ox is not going to the body at all. He'd be so well served to do it though, Teddy.
Yeah, but his opponent doesn't want him to. So, you know, he doesn't want to go against what his opponent doesn't want him to do. Because his opponent would love to keep going to the head because, you know, he can see those coming. He can move and avoid them. Body shots, you know, your head moves, but your body doesn't.
Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Mike Tyson. Well placed right hand from both men. Now this is exactly what I love out of offensive fighters, Teddy. A guy who's able to put together the multi-punch combinations and make it look like it's just the sweet science.
Yeah, exactly. That's what you can do when you have good fundamentals. Not just good physical ability. That's only part of the equation. But just good technical ability. And that's what he's doing. He's snapping his punches. They're nice and clean. They're crisp. They're short. They're together.
Takes one but gets one. Good work by Muhammad Ali. Holy cow! Muhammad Ali is stunned and he is hurt. Able to block that away. It was targeted for his head. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. So the end of the round. And now a chance to put the pieces back together. He got stunned in that last round.
Yeah, well, he has to get those birds out of his head right now. You know, open that cage up and let him fly out there. And the best way to do that is find out why he got stunned. What did he get hit with?
Ali's almost out of it there. He was stunned. Ali blocks it. What a great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Muhammad Ali. And a smart counterpunch by Tyson. Takes one, gives one. The right hand scores well.
Keep the head moving. Then when you punch it.
How important are these mental gymnastics that Muhammad Ali twists and turns, like his pre-fight antics with Sonny Liston, in terms of him getting the results that he wants?
Well, I think he looks for two things. It's a double-edged sword. One is that, you know, he can kind of invade the psyche of his opponent, weaken him a little bit. But it's also for himself. It's to build himself up, to give himself something to aspire to, something to make sure that he lives up to. Puts himself on a spot that now he has to be sure that he handles.
Stay away from the
Mike Tyson. Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. The right hand. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. He just missed that shot up top. Parries that punch intended for the head. Watch the headshot. Ali was able to get to his man in that last round. Now he's got some momentum.
You know, everyone thinks he's not a puncher, but he puts them together. And he put those punches together where he got the effect he wanted.
Round number five has arrived. Muhammad Ali is coming out for this round here, knowing that he was tagged in that last round, Teddy. Now, different guys react in different ways when that happens. It can either bring you up or bring you down.
Exactly. You hit it head on, you embrace it. You embrace it as a challenge. You say, okay, I'm going to show what I'm made of. Or you start to become small. You start to vanish a little bit.
And a smart counterpunch by Tyson. They trade shots. He comes back with a right hand. Oh, he just misses with that headshot.
Teddy, in terms of pure strategy, facing Mike Tyson, what can he take advantage of?
Well, he needs to be set to punch, so obviously you don't want to stand right in front of him. You want to give him angles. You want to give him some lateral movement. You keep him more balanced. Keep his feet moving. If his feet are moving, his hands usually are not coming at you.
A good block by Mike Tyson. Takes one to give one. He comes back with a right hand. Takes one but gives one. Good work by Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson blocking that punch. His attitude in that last round really paid off. You saw he was the much busier fighter.
Over the head. Knock him out. Done.
Let's get on this one. Get the complex over.